Hello from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's discuss the E1 reaction of alkyl halides. So here is our model reaction. In the upper left, we have an alkyl halide, and somehow this is going to undergo an elimination. It's called the E1 after all. It's an elimination, and it's going to generate a new carbon-carbon pi bond, an alkene. E1 reactions are almost always accompanied with heat. And so heat is a driving force. And what that tells you is this is not the most favorable process. It needs a little thermal push. At a lab mate used to call this thermal encouragement. So we need to heat these reactions. From an energy coordinate standpoint, we can see on the right, this is a two-step process. We have two transition states. And therefore, in between, we're going to have an intermediate. And much like the SN1, we're going to have a carbocation intermediate. So these are two of the features that kind of stand out when you look at the reaction coordinate diagram. So let's see a sample reaction. Just like the SN1, which also forms a carbocation, we begin this process by having our halide leave. Our leaving group leaves. So we're going to form a new carbocation. This is a really good carbocation that I've drawn. It, not only is it a tertiary carbocation, but we could also draw some resonance with the double bonds in the benzene ring next door. So this is about as good a carbocation as one can draw. Now, what's going to happen to our carbocation? In an E1 reaction, we're going to form our double bond, and now this starts to look a little bit like an E2 reaction. In the E2 reaction, we removed a beta hydrogen. Beta to what? Well, beta to the carbocation. The carbocation is the carbon that was attached to the halogen. That's our alpha position. And so now we can look next door to that, and we will find a host of hydrogens. Now, I've drawn three on that carbon. There are three more on that carbon right there. So there are lots of beta hydrogens. To remove that beta hydrogen, we need a base. Now, when I say base, don't think, oh, we must need sodium hydroxide, a really strong base. It takes a very, very weak base to do this deprotonation. In fact, I will normally just write B with a lone pair to say there's some kind of base, but it's not hydroxide. It's not that kind of thing. You will not see an E1 reaction with sodium hydroxide in the mix. So don't think E1 needs a base, a strong base. Very weak base. So something in there, weak base, will remove one of these beta hydrogens, and that CH sigma bonding pair will become a carbon-carbon bonding pair. And we'll get something like this. And there's our elimination product. And what we've lost in net is we've lost HI as a net process. And maybe under the heat conditions, you can drive off these small acids sometimes as a gas, and that can help drive the reaction to form your elimination product. So what are our key ideas? Our first key idea, I think, is we need a stable carbocation. So that means we probably need a highly substituted halide in order to form that stable carbocation. The second thing is we need no nucleophiles. If we have a nucleophile present, that nucleophile is going to attack the carbocation just like we saw in the SN1 reaction. So we need to form our carbocation with no nucleophiles around so that we can lose the beta hydrogen and form the alkene in the E1 reaction.